Hello from Chem Help ASAP. In this video, we will discuss the idea of biomarkers, which help measure the effect of a compound in an assay. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to define biomarkers and list examples of different types of biomarkers. So what is a biomarker? Here is a definition from a website from the U.S. Food and Drug Administration. A biomarker is a defined characteristic that is measured as an indicator of normal biological processes, pathogenic processes, or responses to an exposure or intervention, including therapeutic interventions. Biomarkers can serve a wide range of purposes, but we will focus on this last part of the definition, responses to an exposure or intervention. So we are discussing the creation of a new drug, a new therapeutic intervention that will have a beneficial effect, cause a response, when used to treat or cure a disease. The FDA lists four types of biomarkers: molecular, histologic, radiographic, and physiological. Let's talk about representative examples of each of these. While the FDA language leans towards monitoring biomarkers in patients, biomarker discussions are relevant to preclinical studies in animal species as well. So, a molecular biomarker includes hormone levels, cholesterol levels, and electrolytes. Monitoring molecular biomarkers is optimally accomplished through blood or plasma analysis, but that is not always possible. Histologic biomarkers are generally monitored through a biopsy of tissue, which will be stained or otherwise treated for analysis under a microscope to quantify the condition. Radiographic biomarkers are monitored through imaging techniques and could include tumor size or bone density. A radiographic biomarker may be preferable for patients over a histologic biomarker because imaging is less invasive than a biopsy. Finally, a physiological biomarker would include blood pressure, heart rate, and body mass index. Are there things that get measured but are not considered biomarkers? Absolutely. How an individual feels is not a biomarker. So in depression, a patient's attitude or frame of mind is not a biomarker, but certain hormones in the plasma may be a viable biomarker. How an individual functions is not a biomarker. In Alzheimer's disease, a memory test is not considered a biomarker, but measurements from neuroimaging may serve as a biomarker. Many physical therapy programs use tools like the 2-minute step test to gauge a patient's physical ability or degree of recovery. The number of steps a patient takes during this test is not a biomarker. Survival outcomes are not a biomarker. These items, individual feeling, function, and survival, are clinical outcomes and can be diagnostic indicators for the success of a treatment, but these items are not considered to be biomarkers.
We can now define the idea of a biomarker according to the U.S. FDA. We can also list examples of biomarkers based on their type.
I hope this video clarified what is and is not a biomarker. Please consider leaving a like, subscribing, or leave in a comment. Take care.